Hi, have you ever wondered how does a UROFLOW machine work? Do you want to make your own? In this video I will show you how to make one for around 10 euros. This is video 1 of 2-part series coming up! Welcome to my YouTube channel Green-Eyed Explorer, where I explore further and beyond about tweaks, hacks, electronics and house repairs. Hi, in this video we will see what UROFLOW machine is, how to make the machine and also see how to use it. In the second video we will see how to calibrate the machine and what does my firmware offer. Definition and why. First I will explain what UROFLOW machine is. It is an appliance which measures how good your urinary flow is when emptying your bladder. It objectively shows patient status to a urologist. It can show many things. The most known is an obstruction either due to benign prostatic enlargement or other reasons. It is one step of diagnostics called urodynamic studies. It basically is a simple weight scale which shows the volume of voided urine, increase of weight of urine in time in a format, flow per time and some other parameters. As I am a urologist by profession and electronics geek and handyman by heart, I was very keen on making one. My purpose here is to populate this device among men as it can objectively reveal many problems. Parts. I decided to show you how to make a wireless UROFLOW as an added value. It is even cheaper. Most commercial products are either wired or use Bluetooth. I will use ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, a 1 kg digital load cell weight sensor and a HX711 converter. Hardware is really simple and cheap. The biggest challenge about making one was to write the program for it. It contains 3100 lines of code or 100,000 characters. It took me about 20 hours of programming and thinking. All the processing and calculations are done on the microcontroller itself. User just has to visit the web page and see the report and print it. No additional dedicated PC for the UROFLOW machine, which means even lower cost. I offer my schematics and firmware for free for personal use. Commercial usage is negotiable. Data can be found on my homepage and my GitHub page. I also provide the version with nomograms for better interpretation and even a dedicated Windows program with database for storage. Schematics. The schematic is very simple. The weighing element has four wires: red, black, white and green. They come from strain gauges on the load cell. Strain gauges are organized in a Wheatstone bridge. That's why there are four wires. They are connected to a HX711 chip. Red goes to E+ and the black one to E-. E's represent excitation. Meanwhile, white goes to A- and green wire to A+. They are inputs. A input can be programmatically defined as gain of 128 or 64, while input B has a fixed gain of 42. We will use input A with gain 128. Other selectable thing is sample rate. We can choose 10 or 80 Hz. I selected 10 Hz as it has lower noise and gives enough precision. Connection to microcontroller has two communication lines, clock and data line. The only other thing used in this version of the machine is a red LED which lights when there is an ongoing measurement or calibration procedure. Calibration procedure is also initiated via Wi-Fi. Hardware design. Here you can see how a weighing element is mounted. Tray is on the upper side of weighing element. The other side is mounted to the bottom plate. You will need two M3 and two M4 screws and some nuts for spacers. You can see the prototype uses breadboard for connections. If you want to buy parts, the links are in the description below. How to use? First, you will have to put the appliance on a level ground. Put collecting muck on the tray. If it is heavy, leave it there for a few minutes for the load cell to stretch. If you use the machine for the first time or want to recalibrate it after a certain period of time, you initiate the calibration procedure with a known weight via Wi-Fi. The calibration parameters are stored in the machine itself. When measuring the urinary flow, you have to use a white funnel which does not contact the mug or the device. Funnel collects split or spray stream and makes just a slight impact on the measurement. The other important thing is not to touch the device in any way. While voiding, touching makes artifacts. Demonstration. Now I will demonstrate the usage. If the LED is off, one can start. While voiding, the LED is on. The machine even waits for eventual post-void dribbling and stops after a certain time. The on time will be presented on the report. Start and stop are calculated on the fly.